Good morning. It's Wednesday, the 25th of January, 2017. Thought I'd pop in and do a live little show for you this morning, boys and girls, but not looking as it usually does. You didn't get a timer. You didn't get an opening film. There's something's gone wrong with the software that I use. It's like, how can I put this so you will understand? So there's like a camera which goes into the computer. It goes through one lot of software which mixes the camera, the films, any pictures, the timer, all that. That puts all that together. I have like little screens in front of me on there, and they're all there waiting to be sort of switched on, if you see what I mean. And then that goes through another bit of software, which is like the broadcast software, which sends it to Facebook. Now, the broadcast software and the vision mixing software are no longer talking to each other. And I don't know why that is. I've done two updates, so it's even more difficult because I can't work out which one it is. The computer did an update of its usual, you know, security updates and all that business. This happened a few days ago. And I also updated the software because it told me to update it. And since then, I've had this problem. One won't talk to the other. However, it is picking the camera up on its own. That's cutting out the mixing software. So that's why you didn't get a little film at the beginning and you just heard music and me scratching my nose and that sort of thing. Of course, if you're watching the recorded show, you won't get any of that. That also means I can't stick up the phone number. I can't do anything other than turn a camera on and off. How disappointing. I mean, it's almost like I'm only doing half the job this morning, isn't it? And I'd like to apologise on behalf of myself and my systems for that. All right, there is a phone number if you want to call in at some point. It's 020-8144-3477, OK? 020-8144-3477 is the phone number if you want to call in this morning. Let's say hello to some early people. We're early today. Look, this must be the earliest show I've done. It would have been earlier because I've been trying to sort that out and I gave up in the end and just thought, I thought I'd just turn the camera on. It doesn't make any difference to you anyway, probably, does it? There also won't be the little film at the end if you're watching the live show. You'll have to watch it on the recording. I would have been on at about 10 to 9 this morning. I got up at 8. I'm having a trouble sleeping if I don't work. So if I've got a night off, I then have trouble sleeping and it's starting to get on my nerves. It really is. Whether or not that will sort itself out, I don't know. I did go to bed a little bit later last night. I must admit, I watched some television last night. Some TV I'm watching at the moment. Silent Witness. Are you watching that? Oh, it's wonderful. Oh, it's horrible. Oh, it's horrible. It was about those some poor refugees who came to the came over in like a white van. This is what happened to a lot of the refugees. They pay people an awful lot of money. Sell everything. They sell everything, pay people a lot of money. They stick them in the back of a van and they try and get them through like that. That's what happens. Except in this particular programme, there was a bloke who was taking the money, but the bloke he was, I think, paying to bring people across was driving them over in a van and dumping the van with them locked inside. And, of course, they all dehydrated to death. And these policemen come along and open the doors and all these flies come out and there were like mummified bodies of people. And I'm watching this program and I thought, I bet this actually happens. Isn't it awful? Refugees, they must be so, so desperate to get away from places. But of course, you know, they wouldn't expect for one moment that they're going to be locked in a van and that's where they're going to die. Just horrendous. So Silent Witness I'm watching at the moment. Last night, I started watching an excellent programme, Taboo. It's a period drama, boys. You're probably looking at me today, thinking, is this a period drama, aren't you? Do you know what some bloke said to me the other week? He said, you look like something out of the 70s. I had my light blue jacket on. I can't remember what I had under it. Maybe a check shirt. He said, I look something out of the like something out of the 70s. How rude is that? I don't look like something out of the 70s, do I? I don't, do I? Anyway, so you probably thought this was a period drama when you were watching this. But Taboo, that's very good. That's on the BBC One. And I've now got Holby City to watch as well. Wendy has sent us a little message. And Wendy says, past couple of nights, I've been watching a couple of The Hobbit Returns on television. Love those films. I don't remember watching The Hobbit. wasn't it like that other program, that other film? Is it films? I think it's films. There was another one that was filmed in New Zealand. I think there were three of them. And I'm just trying to think of the life of me what it was called now. Perhaps someone a text in and let me know. Anyway, Wendy says, I love the Hobbit films. Have you seen the film Miss Potter about Beatrix Potter? No, I haven't. Renee Zellweger. Is that how you say it? Zellweger plays a blinding part as Potter. It's a wonderful film. Very touching. Oh, I like a bit of a touching. Do you like a bit of touching, Wendy? It's very touching. It's been out on DVD for quite a few years now, but every now and again I dig it out. One of the best films I've ever seen. Just had a read up on Taboo. Sounds like my cup of tea. I will check it out. Yeah, I think you'll like that. I think you will like that, Wendy. And Wendy also says, just watching a show from yesterday, the Eurovision UK's entry will be chosen on Friday, the 27th, so that this coming Friday. But it's going to be on BBC Two colour. And not BBC One. So I didn't know that. I shall set my video recording device. Do not worry, Wendy. I shall record it, my darling. And she says, funny you should mention the big sing on your show yesterday. I've been sharing a few of their videos on Facebook over the past few weeks. And people have been loving them. I love it. I would love to go sometime. Me too. Me too. And Wendy's looking and she says, "I believe, is it just once a year, the big sing? That's where everyone goes to the Royal Albert Hall and sings hymns. You know, the sort of thing, you know. Shine, Jesus, praise my soul. Big, powerful hymns with an orchestra, dear. Not some old dear playing wrong notes on an organ. Carl, dear, have you ever been to a church and there's some old dear? And they're looking at the music like this. They're looking at the music like this. And that, like that, and that. Bless. They do their thing. No, with a big orchestra playing the correct notes. How marvellous. She says they believe, she believes the event usually recorded around September, so it might be a while before tickets go on sale this year. Will keep my eyes peeled. And she's found one. The one in 2016 was recorded on Sunday, the 11th of September. So it must be around then. So we'll have a look at that. We'll have a little look at that. Thank you, Wendy, for sending in your little messages there, my darling. Appreciate that. Lots of people with us already this morning. Good morning to you, boys and girls. Adam's there, Gary Davidson, Gustav. Wendy, as I say, no countdown, correct? I explained that why. Doug is watching in Bangkok. One night in Bangkok. Oh, far too busy for me. I would hate that, Doug. I would hate Bangkok. Too many people in Bangkok. let's see. Aaron says, who is it? Good morning, Aaron. Nice to see you, Aaron. Blah, blah, blah. There's no bloopers, dear. No bloopers. Stella's here. Why are you up and broadcasting so early? I'm back in the A&E department. Because I got up, dear. I got up. I thought we'd have a nice little morning chat this morning. I think that's quite nice. Good morning to Warren Reeves. I'm preparing myself from James O'Brien on LBC. Well, rather you than me, Warren. Oh, I can't stand. Have you heard him? James O'Brien on LBC. Leading Britain's conversation. That's why I don't get the job on there, Warren. You see, I can't even say it. Leading Britain's conversation. Elaine's with us this morning. Good morning, Elaine. Says, I'm just at work right now, so I can't participate. Just wanted to say, Barry Manilow's back. Is the album. They're all going into meltdown now, the Barry Manilow fans. They've released a picture of Barry Manilow in a wonderful red jacket. I bet you didn't get that from Burton's or Topshop. Lovely red jacket. I think I need a red jacket next. I haven't got a red one. What do you reckon? I've got a Union Jack jacket. Have you seen that one yet? I'll try and remember to wear that tomorrow, OK? I've got a Union Jack. I haven't got a red jacket. I think it's something like that, I think. Oh, no, James O'Brien. Has he started yet? He hasn't started yet. He don't start till 10, does he? Good. Switch it off, dear. Try talk radio. There's that lady's on there. Is it Sheila? Oh, no, what's her name? It might be Sheila Fergerty. No, the one that left LBC, I think. She's on there. She's very good. I quite like her very much. dear. Let's have a look. Joanna's with us this morning. At last, you find one of our live our live shows. Good morning, Joanna. And Wendy says, have I got the sequined red jacket? No, that went ages ago. I used to do my bingo nights in a sequined red jacket. Oh, it was lovely, dear. Lovely. Now, we've got a letter to read here that actually came in on Sunday, and I've forgotten to read it, so that's bad on me. So we'll give that a little look at the moment, in a few moments' time. But be very careful. In this morning's Super Soraway Sun, it was gruesome. Oh, yes. A disgusted businessman. Disgusted. Ugh. Disgusted businessman filmed the shocking moment brown sludge poured from the bathroom tap of his luxury hotel in Manchester. Luxury hotel. Let's see where he was staying. Moments after he'd finished brushing his teeth. I think that's a lie for a start. How old is he? Oh, well, he's 43. They'd probably be false. He'll have false teeth. I bet that they've all got false teeth up in Manchester, you know. Yes, have you not seen them? They put them in little jars. Please, brushed his teeth. He probably took them out. there's a lie. What's his name? Wilson. What sort of name is that? Wilson. That's a surname, isn't it? It's not a first name. Wilson Chowdhury, 43, noticed the water started going an unusual colour as he was about to wash his face and quickly began videoing the dark liquid streaming from the faucet. There's a picture of him there. Let's have a look. He looks like one of those people that plucks his eyebrows. What's all that about? Men plucking their eyebrows. It goes on. He initially started filming the water streaming out the shower. Oh, yeah. As one of those people, as he starts filming himself in the shower. Oh, dear. There's something very mucky about that, don't you think? Oh, people, they do. They all put video of themselves doing all sorts of things on the internet now, you know. Amir Khan. Yes, Amir Khan. I've been searching for ages. Can't find that. Very disappointing. He initially started filming the water at the four-star... Well, there you go. Four-star. Four-star Hilton Hotel. Hilton Hotel in Deansgate, Manchester, where he was staying while visiting the city from his home in London. Mr. Chowdhury can be heard in the footage saying, "What is this? I had a shower in this last night. I'm paying $136 night for this. That is a total disgrace. I've never seen anything like it." He then turns to the sink where the brown liquid came from filling the bowl. He said, "You won't believe this. This is water coming out of a tap at the Hilton Hotel. This is the Hilton Hotel, Deansgate, Manchester." And what's he moaning about? Why didn't he just pick up the phone and complain? They would have sorted it out. No, instead he has to write to the Sun. Oh, dear, dear me. He had reported noticing issues with the water pressure the night before and complained to reception. Hello, reception. Isn't it funny? You get you always get witches working on receptions in various places. The worst ones in doctor's surgeries. Witches do have jobs. Where do they work? Doctor's surgeries. Oh, yes. Hello, surgery. Yes, surgery. Can I ask you what the problem is? It's all done in confidence. Oh, really? Here, Joan, we've got another one on here. He's got a discharge. Yeah. No, we don't talk to anyone about your problems at all. Can I ask what colour it is? Oh, my God, it's green. He's telling me it's green. Thank you very much. And when would you like me to fit you in? I've got an appointment. Let's see what the date is today. It's the, there's horrible noise coming out of there. The date is the 25th of January. Yes, we've got an appointment for you in December. Can I fit you in there? Thank you so much. Thank you, bye-bye. No, witches work in doctor surgeries, they do. You've seen them in there. Try and get past one of those. £1,000 usually does it, but there we are. Anyway, the morning after complaining about the water pressure, his sink began filling with water when he noticed it starting to turn a shade of orange and then dark. But what you're complaining about, you miserable old fool. Honestly, miserable old fool. I mean, he would have complained more if body parts started dropping out of the tap, wouldn't he? Or blood. Perhaps someone has been murdered and placed in the room above you. How strange and mysterious. I wonder who's been killed upstairs. Anne says she books her appointments online. Oh, you don't have to talk to any old bag then. Working in the reception, do you, Anne? Congratulations and jubilations. Wendy says, leave us Mancunians alone. Thank you very much. We'll get some decent... Actually, I did stay in a very decent hotel in Manchester. Oh, it was very old-fashioned. Great big staircase and all that. Can't think of what it was called now. There was a music shop opposite it. Any idea what that one was? Don't know. Don't know what it was. No idea what it was. Warren, who's Frost Drop? What are you going? What is Marcella Frostdrop? What's her name? Oh, hang on. Is that Brexit woman? Marcella Frostdrop. Hang on. Let's have a look. If I just type in Marcella, that seems to ring a bell, that name. Marcella. Who's the one that's trying to scupper the... No, I don't know who that... Well, I don't know why you've typed that name to me, Warren. Marcella Frostdrop. Who is Marcella Frostdrop? Who is that person? Now, let me read you this. By the way, have you ever... What's the worst experience you've had in a hotel, eh? Worst experience in a hotel. Do you want to tell me about it on the internet telephone? We have a phone-in number, 020-8144-3477. 020-8144-3477. Only if you're watching live, though, boys and girls, OK? Mariella. Oh, she's a wine... Is she a wine critic? What's that got to do with what we're talking about at the moment? Joanna also does her appointments on the computer. Oh, well, maybe I can do that. Can I do that? I don't know. Mariella. Now, who's Mariella? Mariella Frostrop. I wonder why he's shouting that name at me. I don't know why that... Oh, hang on. Yep, that's coming up now. Oh, wait. Oh, some blonde girl. The Guardian, dear. Oh, you don't read The Guardian, do you? Oh, that left-wing paper, dear. Oh, I meet The Guardian people. Some people work at The Guardian. I do meet them. Oh, they're full of it, dear. Very, very important people, dear. Very, very important people. Dear Mariella. Oh, it's a... Is she like an agony aunt type person? I've never heard of her, dear. That's how popular she is. I've never heard of her, Warren. Who is she? Who are these people? Right, let me read this email then. This is to do with Saturday's show that we did recently. Hi, Chris. Hope all is good. Just a couple of thoughts on Saturday's show. I totally agree with you by what you say about rude people, particularly in audiences. Because, you know, you can't go out to a show now and there are rude people there shouting and screaming. No idea how to behave. You were talking about a drag queen on stage, but they are not the only performers to suffer a rude audience. I think I first became more aware of this lack of respect for performers about 10 years ago when I went to see Ray Davis of the Kinks. Da-na-na-na-na. You really got me. You really got me. Is it that? Was that a Kinks song? I can't remember now. I've noticed that mirrorball is like shining at me. Look. Is that a little shine? It's like a beam coming down from heaven on me today. It really is. I'm not dead, am I? Have I died? I've died and I'm at a radio station, television studio in the sky. Marvellous. I think I first became more aware of this lack of respect 10 years ago when I went to see Ray Davis of the Kinks at Shepherd's Bush. Oh, have you been to Shepherd's Bush? You've been to Shepherd? What a dump that is. They honestly, a Shepherd's Bush Green. They've got this little bit of grass in the middle of one of the busiest roundabouts. It's like a massive roundabout in London. It's not actually a little roundabout, like, you know, it's like a great big roundabout. And the roundabout is so big, they have a fun fair on it sometimes. And the sun comes out in the summer. You can't see the grass through people. And they're dreadful. Oh, ghastly people, dear, living in Shepherd's Bush. Ghastly, awful, dreadful people. They are. And they go over there with their picnics and their cans of lager and their drugs and they're all on the Shepherd's Bush grid. You can't see the grass. It's the tiniest bit of grass ever. And they're all on it. Don't go to Shepherd's Bush. Almost as bad as Croydon, but not quite. Let's see. Wiz says, this is from Wiz, incidentally. Wiz says, now you would have thought when people had paid good money to go to a gig, they would at least have the good manners and respect to listen to the songs. Sing along if they know the words. Oh, how wonderful to go to a sing-along musical, eh? The heels. Oh, I like the nun's one where she stands in front of the mirror. Or is it a window? a mirror or a window. Climb every mountain, search high and low, follow every rainbow. Oh, the mother abbess. It's was it abscess? Has she got an abscess, the mother abbess with the abscess? Does she go to the dentist and she has to get round past the witch receptionist first? We carry on. Since then, hang on a minute. I've missed a bit out there. Good manners, blah, blah, good money to go to a gig when they would at least have the good manners and respect to listen to the songs. Sing along if they know the words. However, I remember that some studio audience members clearly wanted to shout a conversation with their friends, which of course ruined the concert for those people who wanted to enjoy it. Since then, I've noticed that this type of behaviour happens quite a bit, particularly in smaller music venues and pubs, which is a real shame. Oh, I see it all the time. I see it all the time. Personally, if I get a ticket for a show, then I want to see the show. I can talk with my mates in the bar beforehand and after. Oh, it's 10 o'clock. I should have my pills now. Oh, no, I'll wait a little bit. It'll be all right. Half an hour, I think. Yes, I mean, we see it all the time. Rude people. Rude people, they really are. Alan says, I was in that show, The Sound of Music. Oh, really, Alan? What did you actually play when the nuns? Because I'm looking at your picture on the Facebook. You do look like a nun, Alan, I must admit. Are you a nun, darling? Was that in a previous life? Did you get kicked out? Did you get caught doing something naughty? You did, didn't you, Alan? You did, didn't you? Got kicked out of the nuns for being something naughty. Oh, dear. Wendy says, if you're dead, so are we. Are we all dead together? Well, that wouldn't be such a bad thing, would it? If we all died together. Perhaps a nuclear bomb. I mean, that looks possible now, doesn't it? We could have a nuclear bomb flight. Whoa, the ones we're making are going the wrong way. Was it Trident? Push a button, they go the wrong way. God's sake, man. They can't get anything to work. And they want to put those cars on the street that drive themselves. Dear, dear me. let's go on with this email from Wiz. We were talking about a quiz show host the other day on Saturday. Sean Fletcher is the TV quiz show host you were trying to think of. This is the one. Yes, I saw him on a show on Saturday morning, but it was fake. You know, the smiling and the talking, it was all coming off an auto cue. You could tell it wasn't flowing naturally. We'll probably lose Warren now because he's desperate to go and listen to James O'Brien and LBC, aren't you, darling? Enjoy yourself, because I wouldn't. So I was saying it came across as very fat. He's probably very good at reading news. He came from Sky Sports. Yes, there we go. I think he comes from a journalistic background when he was with Sky Sports. Maybe he still is. Perhaps he has a connection with a company who make the quiz. Well, I don't know. But he was the wrong man for the job. It just wasn't natural at all. You know, you get some fantastic news readers, but they wouldn't all be able to do a programme where you interact with people. Some people are good at it. Angela Rippon's fantastic at doing that, isn't she? Angela Rippon and that other one, that posh one in the morning. What's her name? Victoria. She had the breast cancer thing, didn't she? Victoria, I can't think of her name now. Victoria, she's very good at interacting with people. Although, if you don't mind me saying so, Victoria Lovey, you're a bit aloof. A bit aloof. You're not kind of down at our level, are you, my lovey? No. Finally, Wizzo says, if you believe in something, then it's worth keep plugging away. Like me doing this, you know. 11 years, we're still waiting to get somewhere, but never mind. I've always maintained, if you write a good song, then eventually it will become a hit. Or if you're a good radio or TV presenter, then your day will come. What's her name sings about that? Oh, the lovely girl from Camden who died. Rehab. Amy Winehouse. She sings about that. Your day will come. Or something like that, I think. If you are sufficiently determined to succeed. Ah, well, that's the thing, you see. I'm not very determined, am I? You know, I found, like, I like to do this, and I think this is where it's going to stop, Wizzo. We must be realistic, dear. We must try and be realistic, lovey. It's a bit annoying when you see the less talented appearing to do it, though I say what you reap is what you sow. Well, yes, I mean, we see it all the time on the telly. untalented people now, dear. Dreadful people on the telly. Awful, awful. That's it, and we'll see you at the quiz tonight. Yes, Wizzo is coming along to the quiz this evening. He comes along with Ray Reynolds, and I don't know if anyone else is coming tonight, but they won a few weeks ago, so I think they've got winnings to spend, or have they spent that already? Oh, I can't remember now. Possibly, quite possibly, quite possibly. All right, let's have a look. We've got some... the Angel Delights. Here it is, the Angel Delight. Now, I promised you that I would have a little Angel Delight film for you today, didn't I? But I didn't get it done. Because yesterday after I finished the show, we went swimming. Had a little bit of a swim there. It was quite busy in there yesterday, actually. Then we went to see a film. I can't remember the title. It's Something Beasts. Unusual Beasts. Let me find the title. One moment, please. Beasts. Film. Let's see if I can find that for you. Beasts film. Fantastic Beasts, which is an excellent film. A really, really good film. If you like Harry Potter, you will like Excellent Beasts. All right, boys and girls, you really will like that. So we saw that yesterday. I won't tell you what happens in it, but it involves lots of wonderful little beastie type things, you know. Little insect, large insects and like perhaps this great big bird thing, and it's got a lovely ending. You'll love the ending. So that's all I'm going to see. Now, it has been out for a while, but if you go, you'll have to go quickly, otherwise it'll stop being on there. We saw it in 3D once again, and I do have a problem with 3D because it makes the screen a bit darker and I have trouble seeing some of it. I really do, and I don't really like going to see 3D films now. For the amount the screen dims, it's not worth the effects to me. I'd rather go and see it in 2D. So there we are. Phone call coming in. Good morning, Adam the Plumber.
Good morning, Chris Ridden, international DJ and superstar television personality of the year 2005, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 and 16.
Thank you for giving my correct titles, my darling. You're the only one that does that. Good morning, Adam. How are you today?
I'm very well, thank you, Chris. And yourself?
And what are you calling in to this worldwide phenomenon with 5 million viewers at the moment this morning? Oh, the phone's ringing. Just a moment, please, Adam. We're going to line one. Good morning. Oh, good morning, friend. How are you today? Best friend, how are you today? They can't hear you, by the way. This is a private conversation. I'm just talking to millions of people and I take a call from my friend. Isn't that interesting? Carry on. Are you wanting to come round, dear? Not a lot. Yes. Do you want to go to Waitrose? We went yesterday, dear. Oh, okay then. What time will you be here? There is no rush today. No rush. Terrible night's sleep again, dear. Oh. And yeah, it's when I was just telling my millions of people I have trouble sleeping when I haven't worked. Do you see what I mean? So I don't know. Work it. Dun, 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 dun. Who does that one? Work it. Is that Missy Elliott? Missy Elliott. I quite like Missy Elliott. Bum bum bum. A new group. Who are they? Oh, work. No, that's, yes, Fifth Harmony, Work From Home. Anything you need to know about music or any subject at all, I know everything. Remember that, lovey. Thank you. Goodbye. This call has become very boring. I'll see you soon. Thank you. Sorry. Pardon?
Good morning, Chris.
Sorry, it's getting very boring again, dear. I hope you didn't hear that rude word that he reiterated while I was doing my programme, dear.
I hope not. No, I didn't hear it at this end.
Anyway, carry on. We were listening to you, Adam. Commence your conversation.
Yes, OK. Yeah, so basically I was ringing in to say about this water tank episode at the hotel.
Oh, yes, and, go on.
To advise your viewers. I'm not sure how many people realise, but a lot of the time your bathroom tap in your bathroom is actually connected to a cold water storage tank in your loft.
Yes.
And that can, if it's not cleaned regularly or drained regularly, can harbour some nasty little things in it. And we brush our teeth in that.
Oh, Well, I mean, so I brush my teeth. You take your one, aren't you? You take yours out and clean them under the tap, dear.
I do, but I clean them under the kitchen. I clean them under the kitchen tap. hold on a minute, dear. Let me just see what's on LBC. Hold on, sorry. What? Yeah, I'm back with you now. Sorry.
Sorry?
Yeah. So.
What do you mean? What's on LBC? I beg your pardon. Turn that off immediately.
You're telling me people. That
it's only Mr. Left Wing Jamo. It's that left wing idiot, James O'Brien. Oh, I can't bear him, dear.
Left wing? Don't mention left wing on this channel.
Oh, he's left. That's an understatement, dear. He's right over the other side of the planet. And all he does is moan and moan and moan. I can't bear people that moan all the time. I really can't, lovey.
No, I just don't see the point of it. I mean, you're not one to moan, are you?
No, I'm glad I'm not, dear.
No, oh God, no. Can you imagine if you moaned?
Anyway, so you're saying that the water that comes out of the cold tap in your bathroom from that tank is not always clean, aren't you, dear?
That's right, so, yeah. I always advise people to clean their teeth in the kitchen sink.
Being the UK's most famous and popular undercharging plumber, items have you found in people's water tanks? Now, get ready, everyone. If you're having your breakfast, especially if it consists of a dead animal of some sort, you may well want to put your little knife and foot. Shania will be sitting there at the moment having one of her very large fried breakfasts with her brother Callum. Yes.
Oh, of course. Yes,
as cook's pub. So what sort of things have you found in people's water tanks?
Mainly debris from where roofers have replaced the roof. So you get little bits of debris in tanks.
Don't they have a lid on them then?
They do sometimes. It depends. If people, you know, if a plumber's been up there and taking the lid off to replace the ball valve and forgot to replace the lid, or sometimes if they're older tanks, they don't have lids. They have just bits of wood over them. When I was a lot younger, I used to go out with my dad, who was a plumber, and one day we were up in the loft and they kept on complaining that this tank kept on stopping after a while. So we lifted the lid and there's a dead pigeon floating on the top of
pigeon?
It. Pigeon? Pigeon, yeah.
Pigeon, I like pigeons.
I love pigeons, I think they're lovely.
They don't make any, boo, boo, boo. That's a pigeon, isn't it? Boo.
It is.
Boo, boo. Can you do a pigeon, Adam?
Oh, let's see. Pigeon impression.
That's very good. That's very, very good indeed. But don't do that near... Who is it that wanted all the pigeons to stop coming into Trafalgar Square? Was that Red Ken?
Oh, I can't remember.
I think that was Ken Livingstone. I quite like Ken Livingstone. He speaks his mind. I like people that speak their minds, not those that hide behind little bits and pieces.
When I was a lot younger, actually, one of my first enterprising businesses when I was about 10 or 11 was to undercut the pigeon seed sellers in Trafalgar Square. What I used to do was go to a pet shop in North London.
Now, keep the phone in one place, dear. You're moving that phone around, dear.
There we go. I'll stay.
Either that or go to speakerphone. Go to speakerphone. Let's try that.
Okay, we're on speakerphone. How's that? Is that any better?
Actually, that's fantastic. Yes.
Good. Okay, we'll start on speakerphone. Right, so basically what happened was...
Now, you've moved it again. You've moved away from it.
I'll come right close. I'll come close as I can to you. How's that?
That's too close.
How's that?
No, yeah, okay.
Modulation okay?
Yeah, just about, but don't move your head around.
Testing, 1, 2, 3.
Get on with it, dear.
Okay, so when I was about 10 years old, I went to a pet shop in Wood Green.
Yes.
And bought a bag of bird seed. I then proceeded down to Trafalgar Square, where I used to sell the bird seed for 10 pence a cup. And I used to retrieve the cups from out the fountain that the people would leave behind after they fed the pigeons. And that was one of my very first enterprising businesses.
And reuse them?
And reuse the lids that the... Because obviously they used to give like these... they were like lids off of air fresheners, that type of thing. That sort of size.
I'm with you, yes.
And they used to sell the pigeon feed, or whatever you want to call it, for 15 pence per cup.
So you undercut them, dear.
So I undercut them and got them for 10 pence.
Very good. Very good indeed. I know a manager that we've both worked for, dear, that reuses plastic glasses.
Oh, right, yes, I know.
Not the large ones, the small shot ones. He reuses them, dear.
Oh, dear, there's a surprise.
I mean, when it's birdseed, 10p a cup, yeah. But when you're buying a shot and it's £5, you expect a new little plastic cup, don't you, dear?
You would do, wouldn't you? And that was another thing the other day. You're talking about going on to pubs and drinks. I was in a pub the other day that shall remain nameless. And because I'm on this Slimming World diet, I've decided to knock all the fizzy drinks and everything on the head. And I ordered a bottle of water. How much do you think I was charged, Chris, for a tiny little 30 centilitre?
£1.50.
Sorry?
£1.50.
Higher.
Higher or lower?
Higher.
Higher? £2.
Higher.
£3?
£2.30.
What, for a little bottle of water?
Yeah, you know those panda pop size ones?
That's a lot of money, love. Lot of money.
I know.
Take your own in. I've seen people in there and they got drink in their little handbags. I've seen that before.
I think I might have to start bringing a handbag in.
Oh, Adam, always a pleasure to talk to you, sir.
So, advice of the day then, Chris, is never drink the water from your bathroom tap unless you know it's main water. Always brush your teeth in the kitchen sink using the tap there.
I think that's excellent advice. Excellent advice.
And one final piece before I go. Always check your stock cocks are well lubricated at this time of year in case of frozen pipes.
That's very, very important. I had a stuck stock cock once. Fortunately, it was noticed it was stuck when someone had come in to do a bit of work for me. So it wasn't a leak or something. But he told me every few weeks, just give it a little turn. Doesn't have to go all the way, you know, just a quarter of a turn and then turn it back again and that'll release, that will stop it seizing up. Is that correct, Adam, the plumber?
Right, yeah, always give him a little squirt of WD-40. Other oils are available. Give it a little wiggle backwards and forwards to make sure it's working.
Now, what are you doing
and
now?
More importantly, know where it is as well. The amount of people I go to and say, where do you turn off your water? And they go, I don't know.
Yeah, exactly.
You're the plumber, you tell me.
Have you just started an engine?
They can be on the kitchen sink, upstairs, or sometimes out in the street. So always check them, especially this time of year. You'll save yourself a fortune on call-outs, having your plumber out at the weekend if you get a bird pipe. At least you can turn it off till Monday morning.
Have you just started an engine, dear?
So there we go, Chris.
Can you hear me?
Lovely.
Hello?
Hello, I'm still here. Are you still there?
Did you just start an engine or something? You couldn't hear what I was saying then.
Oh, sorry about that, dear.
I think you need to go back to an iPhone 6. Those iPhone 7s are dreadful.
I know. I mean, you know, the fact that I'm on loudspeaker to talk to you. There we go.
You're drifting in and out. Well, when we finish the show, have a little listen back to it. You come in at about 33 minutes. Go forward 33 minutes and listen to your conversation with me and you'll see what I mean, my love, all right?
All right, Chris, thanks again.
Have lovely a lovely, lovely morning. Goodbye to Adam the Plumber.
Bye-bye.
Bye, Ads. There we are, Adam the Plumber calling in there. It's always a pleasure to hear little Adam, isn't it, my darlings? Just a couple of more messages and then we'll disappear for the day, boys and girls, OK? Wendy says, it's that iPhone 7 he's got, Chris. They are crap. Was talking to Adam the other day and he got it changed and it's just as bad. Yes, it is. And Ronnie's got one as well and it's exactly the same. The moment he moves the phone... And the funny thing is, the person, not Adam, but the person who's on the iPhone 7... doesn't believe the fact that you've suddenly lost his voice. They don't believe you. And like, can you move your phone back? I have moved it back. They don't believe you. And the only way to prove it is to make a recording of the phone call and then play it back. Oh, you're right. Of course I'm right. Oh, Chris Ritter, dear. Always right. Thank you, Wendy. Good morning to Michael Tracy is with us this morning. We're about to disappear. Morning to Mark. Good morning, Mark C. Haven't seen you at the karaoke recently. I know you was at Hendon last night, weren't you, love? Kevin Webster's with us as well. Good evening to the lovely Diane Horan-Hill. Very, very talented lady who says, hi, Chris. Talking about the shows tonight at the Royal Vauxhall Tavern, Heart and Soul. She's in a group called Heart and Soul. Fantastic singer she is. Danny Beard, Dr. Wolf. Is it Aletia? Aletia? How do you say that? I don't know that. Aletia, possibly. Crystal Ball, Strawberry Whipper performing for Cancer is a Drag. Great night of entertainment, £10 on the door towards a great cause. If you would be grateful, thanks, honey. So that's what's happening tonight at the Royal Vauxhall Tavern in aid of Cancer is a Drag. £10 on the door and probably a big bucket going round as well, all right? Hello to Wendy again. She says, I had some a Strawberry Angel Delight a few weeks ago. Loved it. Yes, I didn't get time to do that yesterday. However, I did buy some proper milk in which I shall use to make that one. Now, I have had a little message here from the lovely Martin Rutherford. Good evening, Martin. Who says, Angel Delight, what are we going to do with you? Because I'm having trouble making me Angel Delight. It's not setting. It's like a very delicious strawberry Ed's Diner milkshake type. It comes out like that, but it's not setting. I have been using soya milk, and I think that's the problem. Martin says, Angel Delight, what are we going to do with you? Don't answer. Look at this video, but don't put it in the fridge. I always thought you had to put it in the fridge. Don't put it in the fridge. It will take forever to set, and you must whisk until it's thick and creamy. We'll await your results on the show tomorrow, which is today, but I haven't done it yet. Giza loves listening to your show now as well. Oh, I'm so pleased. More viewers. Thank you very much. So I will get this done at some point, and I'll leave it. I'll tell you what, I'll do one with soya milk and one with normal milk, and I'll leave them both out of the fridge, and we'll see what happens with those two, OK? Joanna reckons 13 and a half stone, which is what I am, is not overweight. It's average. How tall are you? Oh, I'm not tall. About 5'8". But I'm a small person. Small and compact. Small person. That's me. Simon says, Colours in Romford, which is the club I used to work at about 15 years ago now. There's an old picture I was showing yesterday. I found this old poster that I made, and there's a very picture of a young... Oh, that's not me. Can you spot... Which one am I? Can you spot? Look how young I am there. Young and thin. Young and thin. Simon says, Colours in Romford. When I lived in Brighton, I used to go to Romford Ritzy on Saturdays, sometimes all the way at the top of those stairs, 1994-ish. Well, that would be round about when I was at Colours, about 1994. It was a good club, the Ritzy. Good luck to your two pals on the Eurovision song choosing thing. But it is a waste of time us entering now. If we're going to leave the EU, we're not going to get anything from our neighbours. So it's just a pointless exercise, Chris. I think you're right. Who's going to vote for us? No one is going to vote for us at the Eurovision. They are not going to vote for us, are they? No, not a catch, chance in hell. Very, very good chance. I'd put money on being bottom. I would put money on becoming bottom again. Absolutely. And on the subject of the two pictures I showed you yesterday, one of Shania and her breakfast, I'm sure it was her breakfast, but she says, I know I'm telling the truth, so that's all that matters. It was definitely Callum's breakfast. We need photographic evidence, Shania, of Callum eating his breakfast in bed. I'm sorry, a picture is everything, my love, all right? And Danny, I showed you a picture of Danny's legs yesterday, and I did say that he does need to put a bit of meat on those. You know, a little bit more muscle, maybe a few extra bags of chips. Danny does say his legs are nice. Well, we all see ourselves in different ways, Danny. We do see ourselves in different ways, darling. All right. Tonight, now, let me see. It's birthday time. Yes, let's do today's birthdays. Happy birthday today to the lovely Bernadette Lake. Oh, I actually haven't seen you for two years now, because I haven't managed to get round to you on the last two Christmases, have I? So happy birthday today to Bernadette, all right, my sweetheart. Rod Brown, who's become a regular correspondent to this programme. Happy birthday to Rod Brown today. To John McGinley, happy birthday, John. Now, is that the John who likes Doctor Who's? Let me see. Oh, no, that's another John. Sorry, John. There is a John I know who's a big Doctor Who, well, a Doctor Who fanatic. I'm a fan. He's a fanatic. Oh, yeah, wears all the clothes and all that, goes to all the conventions. And he's met Tom Baker. Yes, the other John has met Tom Baker. Have you met Tom Baker yet, John? No, happy birthday, John. Happy birthday to Ray Bersales, 32 years old today. To Simon Garrett, 32 today as well. Katy Lawrence is 36 years old today. Russell Levine's birthday, picture of him catching a fish. Steve Dreadinhoe Campbell is 43 today. Chris Danat, it's his birthday today. I think, do you do something on Radio Caroline? Let me have a quick look. I think you might do something on, yes, Caroline, Caroline. Oh, I love the jingles. The Radio Caroline jingles. They used to be a pirate ship on a boat many, many years ago in the 60s. Happy birthday to John Kempton, who's 29 years old today. To the lovely Jackie Evans, it's her birthday today. And to Nicolas Madeau, who's 45 years old today. They're all our birthdays this morning, boys and girls. Oh, hang on, wrong tune. Wrong tune. Here we are, wrong tune. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. All right. Have a lovely birthday, boys and girls. And that's it from me today. Just to let you know, being a Wednesday night, I'll be hosting karaoke this evening. No, incorrect. Being a Wednesday night, I'll be hosting a quiz night tonight. That's at the King's Head Theatre Bar in Upper Street, Islington. Starts at 8.30 and finishes at 10.30. Now, it's always a good idea, if you're going to come along to the quiz in Islington, to ring ahead and book a table. I suggest you do it now if you want to come tonight, because those tables do get filled up. All right? So, do you want the phone number? I never give out the phone number to this thing. King's Head. Let me look up the phone number for you. King's Head Pub, that's the one. Because there's two numbers. There's one for the theatre and one's for the pub, I think. Contact, there it is. Here we go. If you want to ring ahead and book a table for the quiz, call 020 7. I say that right. 020 7226 4443. Okay? Once again, 020 7226 4443, and you can book a table there, and that'd be nice and comfortable. Arrive 10 minutes within your table. So it's a quiz night tonight and every Wednesday from 8.30 at the King's Head Theatre Bar in Islington. That's all today. Thank you very much for watching and listening.